Hi there, Saturn class. We're going to carry on our work with the compass today, and we're going to look at the four intercardinal points. Intercardinal is a very posh word, and it means the bits in between north, east, south and west. So north, east, south and west are the main points, but we have another four, and they each sit between those main four, and they are known as northeast, southeast, southwest, and northwest. There they are in red. So they sit in between each of the main four points. A really good practical way of looking at a compass is to actually draw one out on a piece of paper for yourself to be able to use, because we need to look at the turns between each point. That's what we're going to be doing today. So if you can, pause the video and draw this one out for yourself. It looks like an asterisk, a star. It's got 8 points. Use a ruler, make it neat. So we're going to go through some questions using the language of turn, using the language of degrees, and using the language clockwise and anti-clockwise. So clockwise is the direction that a clock turns. Anti-clockwise is the opposite direction. So on your piece of paper, you can draw some arrows to show clockwise, going round in that direction. And you can draw another arrow going the opposite direction, anti-clockwise. So we've got a question here. It says I'm facing northeast and I turn 90 degrees anti-clockwise. So there's northeast, and I need to turn 90 degrees anti-clockwise. Now anti-clockwise is the opposite way to the clock. We can see I'm facing northeast, and actually if I turn my head slightly and I look at 90 degrees, I can see there that that is the same as a quarter of a turn. So I end up facing northwest. Well done if you spotted that. If you didn't, don't worry. There'll be a few more questions to have practices with. So here's my compass points again, all 8 of them. This time I'm facing southwest. The red arrow down here will help you with this as well. I'm facing southwest. I'm going to turn 180 degrees clockwise. Now we know that 180 degrees is a half turn, so my half turn means I'm going to be facing the opposite way to the way I started. So I will end up facing northeast. Now with the compass that you've drawn, you can, if you're able to, you can come up with your own questions for your compass. So for example, where you start facing, questions like the ones we've just been doing. So I'm facing southwest and I turn 180 degrees clockwise. Or you might say I'm facing west and I turn 90 degrees anti-clockwise. Okay, so you can have a bit of a play and be quite practical with that activity. We'll go through one more here. But this time it's a bit different because we're not doing quarter turns anymore. We're actually doing half of a quarter turn, which is an eighth. Now, if you look at the compass, it's split into 8 parts. We go back to our work on fractions. We know each one is an eighth. When we look at these, they are actually 45 degrees, because 45 degrees, so in between each point of the 8 points, in between each of the 8 points, there are 45 degrees, because 45 degrees is half of 90 degrees. So if we add our 40 degree there and our 40 degree here, we will see that that's 90 degrees. There's a diagram here that will show you that. So we can see we've got a 45 degree angle between east and northeast, and between north and northeast we are going to have the same, because double 45, two lots of 45, is 90. So there's our compass points again, and this time we're now going to do a 45 degree turn. We're going to go clockwise, but we're going to start at northwest. So there's northwest, and we're doing our 45 degree turn clockwise. Clockwise is the way a clock turns. So where are we going to end up with our 45 degree turn? If you said north, well done. So 45 degrees is between each of the 8 points. So here's my compass one more time, and this time I need to do, start at east, and this time I need to do 135 degrees anti-clockwise. Now, we already know some of these degrees. We know 90 degrees is a quarter. We know 180 degrees is a half. We know 270 degrees is 3/4. And we know 360 degrees is a whole turn. But we're not really sure on 135. But you can probably guess, if you already know that you're going to have a 90, and then you're going to have a 45, because 90 add 45, you may need to do a calculation in your head, we would have a 90 degree turn and a 45 degree turn together. So here we go, we're facing east, we need to do a 90 degree anti-clockwise, we're going anti-clockwise. That would take us to north, but we need to do a bit more. We need to do a 45 degree turn on top of that to make 135 degrees. So I would end up facing northwest. So 135 degrees has made me turn 1/8, 2/8, 3/8. Right, so now, in your Inspire books, you're going to turn to page 119 and 120. I will work with you through some of it, or, if you would like to, you can go and do it completely by yourself. Pause the video now, have a go. Where it says there for a challenge, you can do pages 121, 122. That's not the page numbers. You will see that it's actually page 123. And 124. So just go steady with that. I'm sorry, I made a mistake on my page numbers. Okay, so I've opened up my Inspire book. I'm going to go through a few questions with you, and what I'll do is I'll go through, say, a couple of examples, one or two examples. Then I'll say pause the video, and then you can have a go yourself. But I will go through the questions, because we really need to be making sure we're reading the questions. So the first one here, we're going to look at the diagram below. What is the direction of each letter from X? So X is in the middle. Now you can see here this is A, D, E, F. Well, that's not north, northeast, east, and then southeast like we've been doing. So I've actually started putting mine in, because that will help me with this. So, okay, and remember I said to you, you could draw one out. So if you haven't done so already, it might help you with this particular task. It will probably help you further on down as well. So I'm going to do D. Now I need to know where D is from X. So here's X, and D is at the point northeast. So I write in my northeast. Okay, you can pause the video and have a go at those ones. Okay, so number two. Here I've underlined the important part, so now I'm going to read it back to you. If you are facing north, what is the angle that you will turn through in a clockwise direction to face? So we're looking for the angle. So already I know I've got to use this symbol here, that degrees symbol. Now, I'm going to start facing north, and what I will do is on the side of my page, I will draw that out. But you might need to use quite a few If you want to, you can keep drawing them out because it does help you visualise it and really picture it in your mind. So now I've got to start at north and I've got to go in a clockwise direction to face northwest. So I've got to go all the way round to face northwest. Now if you remember, each one of these was 45 degrees, because I'm going to need to know that, because I'm not going all the way around, I'm going to stop part way through. So I've got a quarter turn, which is a 90, a half turn, which is 180, three quarters, which is 270. So I'm going to write that down, because that's the nearest point to where I need to stop. Now here, this, if you remember, is how many degrees? That's right, it's 45 degrees. So we need to add those together. You can do some mental maths or a column method here. So I need to add those. 5, 7 and 4, 11, 2 and 3. Sorry, 2 and 1 more is 3. Okay, so my answer is 315 degrees. So remember, we're going in a clockwise direction and you'll start at north all the way, all the time. Have a go at those ones. Pause the video. Okay, now for this one, for number 3, we need to look at the direction that the letters are from each other. So it's like a little map. We've got our compass point here. North is going up the top. So Q, we'll read the example. Q is northeast of P. Or shall we check? There's P. Sorry, there's Q. Silly me. There's Q. And P, if we draw the line, we can see that it is northwest. If I were to think, oh yeah, northeast, sorry. So it's northeast. Let's do B. Here's O. And I need to know where it is of M. Okay, well there's M. And O is, I come down, so it's south of M. Okay, I'll do that one more time. K. K is something of Q. Well, there's K. Let's go back to Q, because that's where we need to start, really. K is west of Q. So in other words, each time I'm thinking about those compass points and whereabouts those letters are from each other. So pause the video clip and have a go at 3. Now for number 4, if you need an adult to help you read the question again, please do try and get help so that you fully understand what you have to do. So here we go, we've got to look at the diagram below. So here's our diagram. Farha wants to move from point P to point Y. There's point P. Okay, and there's point Y. In the diagram, we're going to trace one possible route that Farha can take. We do not use more than 5 steps for each route. A possible route is shown in the diagram. So on the diagram, you can see in grey, we've got a line for a route. Do not use more than 5 steps for each route. Okay, so we're not going all over the place. I'm going to try and do it in 5 steps. She can only move along the grid lines and must not cross any of the other marked points. So she can't go on to R or on to S or across up to T. She has to go along the grid lines without touching the dots. So there are many answers that she could possibly do. Here's one. She could start at P. South 1. West 4, North 1, West 2, and then finish it off, North 2. And then what you would need to do is write each step into the grid, into the table below. So remember, she's not to go near these dots. There's another one. We could go up, Oh, sorry, north. Okay. So, have a ponder on that one. If you need to pause the video, then please do. Number five, when I've done this before, in year four, we always get this slightly jumbled up in our brain. So what it's asking for is the fraction of turn. So fill in the spaces, use the compass to help you. So we've got a compass, we're facing south, and what we need to do is write the fraction of turn. So not the degrees this time, the fraction of turn. So you're facing south, you make a something turn in a clockwise direction, you will be facing east. So it tells you where you're starting, it tells you where you finish, but it doesn't tell you the fraction that you're turning. So I'm going to start with my south. You can see I've already included my clockwise direction. I'll keep going round because I haven't finished at east like the question wants me to. Now I've finished at east. 1/4, 2/4, 3/4. Okay, so just be aware that we want the fraction of turn. Okay, you can pause the video and have a go at that one. Okay, Saturn class, if you remember, I also said that there is some challenging work to recap our angles. That's on page 121. Okay, read the question carefully. You worked really well on angles, so just have a go. You'll be fine. Have the best go that you can. And then, silly me, got the page number wrong. It's actually page 123, using our map work again. Use the example to help you. And then page 124, we've got some problem solving. Okay, please do not, I repeat, do not do any of the review work. We are going to do that another time. Okay, so you can stop at page 124. Okay, good luck everybody.